Good evening and welcome. Let's take a look at our top story this hour. India has rejected China's renewed claim to the Galwan River Valley in Ladakh, which has become a flashpoint between India and China. The Ministry of External Affairs of India has released a statement which says, and I quote, "The attempt by the Chinese side to now advance exaggerated and untenable claims with regard to the line of actual control are not acceptable," unquote. Earlier, the Chinese Foreign Ministry had said that the Galwan Valley is located on the Chinese side of the line of actual control in the west section of the China-India boundary. For many years, the Chinese border troops have been patrolling and on duty in this region. This is the second time China has made a claim over Galwan Valley. China says that its troops have patrolled the river valley for many years, but the ground reality is that Galwan Valley lies on the Indian side of the LAC and has never before been a point of contention between the two sides. It was the PLA that first claimed sovereignty over the Galwan Valley immediately after the face-off was confirmed. The Indian Foreign Ministry dismissed the claim as exaggerated and untenable. Beijing once again blamed India for triggering Monday's standoff. Foreign Ministry statement went on to say that since April this year, Indian troops have unilaterally built roads, bridges and other facilities in Galwan Valley. China accused Indian troops of deliberately trying to change the status quo at the border. Our principal diplomatic correspondent, Sidhant Sibyl, is joining us for more on this. Good evening to you, Sidhant. Now, India has categorically rejected Chinese claims over the Galwan Valley incident. The MEA has said that it was China that had been hindering normal and traditional patrolling patterns since May, which of course in turn has resulted in that violent clash. What else has the MEA said?
Well, Alison, it's a pretty significant statement, and it's the second time in past few days that India has rejected Chinese claims over the sovereignty for the Galwan Valley, because remember, it's yesterday that the Chinese Foreign Ministry put out a detailed statement saying that Galwan Valley belongs to China, and it's a rebuttal to that statement because China has been claiming that so since the 15th of June standoff between the both the countries. But what is significant about this statement is the fact that it details the entire situation since May, what has been happening between India and China at the LAC. So the detailed statement gives the timelines and says that since May there have been standoffs, and in fact there have been skirmishes as well between both the countries. In fact, in mid-May, what the MEA says is that the Chinese tried to transgress into the LAC, and that was stalled by a strong response. An appropriate response was given by the Indian Army, and then thereafter there was the 6th of June meeting. That was the meeting after which a consensus was arrived between both the Indian Army and the Chinese Army that there should be disengagement. But what the Chinese did, and they have been doing in the past as well, stabbing in the back, they did not follow the consensus and in fact tried to unilaterally change the situation on the ground, and that led to the skirmishes and a standoff on 15th of June that led to the death of 20 Indian soldiers. Of course, there are casualties on the Chinese side as well, but the Chinese government hasn't released the number. But by and large, it is a point-by-point detailed statement, the first major detailed statement, but also the fifth reaction by the MEA on the standoff between both the countries that led to the death of 20 Indian soldiers on 15th of June. And a significant one, and given the fact that how the Indian Prime Minister has also spoken two times about giving a befitting reply to the Chinese, we have seen a growing sentiment against China here in India. And this happening at a backdrop of a lot of comments, negative comments coming from the Chinese army, or whether it's by the Chinese foreign ministry. In fact, we have seen how the Chinese Chinese government, perhaps or someone in the Chinese government, has been removing statements put in place by the by the Indian mission on Chinese apps, whether it is WeChat or whether it's their counterpart of the Twitter clearly these statements have been removed at the behest of someone powerful in the government there in China, and these statements have been put in place by the Indian mission, and removing them is like the Indian government saying that the statement put in place by the Chinese foreign ministry or perhaps the Chinese embassy should be removed. But that cannot happen here in India, given the fact that it's a democratic country, and perhaps to change the narrative or to control the narrative, the Chinese government has removed these statements. But by and large, we see an increased tension between New Delhi and Beijing amidst the COVID pandemic. We have seen how China has been very belligerent when it comes to the entire neighborhood, whether it's India, Vietnam, Indonesia, Malaysia. There's a list of countries amidst the COVID pandemic, and we all know the origin of COVID as well. So clearly China is of course facing the pressure, but despite the pressure, it is trying to destabilize not just the region but the entire world.
Sudan, thank you for that report. That's our principal diplomatic correspondent, Sudan Sobol, bringing us the latest on the tensions there in Ladakh, and of course he will keep us up to date with any future developments.